All right, today we're going to be changing this hub and bearing on this Honda Pilot. So this Honda Pilot has a growling noise that sounds like it's wheel speed while you're driving down the road. Pretty noisy on this one. If you do some slight S curves back and forth while you're driving, that noise will change. It'll get louder and quieter as it loads and unloads that wheel bearing. So we raised this thing up and we spun the wheel and listened with a stethoscope to diagnose that it is the right-hand side. So we're going to start by getting these brakes off here, and then we need to take the axle nut and rotor off here. So we're going to loosen this axle nut and the rotor screws and get all that off out of the way, and then we'll take that hub off. So we'll start by getting these brakes off. So we're going to break the two brake caliper bolts loose first. That's on the brake caliper bracket. We'll take it off as an assembly. Both those bolts out there, we'll wiggle this caliper off here. We want to make sure and hang it up on this caliper hanger here so we don't let it hang by the hose. We want to make sure that hose isn't holding the weight of it. So next thing is we're going to loosen this axle nut here. So this axle nut is staked, has a little dimple in it there. So we're going to take a punch and open up that stake there. We're gonna use our big 36 millimeter to loosen this up. Get that out of the way. Next thing is we're going to loosen our two rotor screws. These can be pretty tight, so what we're going to use is this impact driver. Find the appropriate bit for it, and you put it on here, and you're going to be twisting it in the direction that you want to go. So we're going to be twisting left while hitting it. That's going to break those loose. Now with these rotor screws out of there, we can take the rotor off the hub. If it has some rust between, we can always use these two threaded holes with a couple bolts. So we've got a couple 8 millimeter bolts we'll thread in here. What these are gonna do is they're gonna push the rotor off the hub. So this one doesn't have a ton of miles on it and it's not very rusty, but it's still a good idea to take your time. So just like that, it's gonna press that rotor off. So we'll get it free and clear that way. So now all we lack is these four main bolts that hold the hub to the knuckle assembly. So we're gonna get those loosened up. Let's see. So sometimes these are a little tricky. You do wanna make sure that you're careful that we don't damage this CV boot while we're doing this. So we're gonna be a little careful here. I'm gonna zip these guys out with a impact. But you do want to keep an eye on, make sure you don't damage that CV boot there. Now that we have all four of those out of there, our hub should just wiggle off there. Looks like it's a little bound up on this axle, so we're going to tap carefully, get that freed up. You want to make sure to be careful when you're hammering it so you don't damage the threads. Now we're freed up. Wiggle it off here. Catch our dust shield. That's it. That's as easy as it is getting it off there. So this particular wheel bearing has a magnetically encoded wheel speed sensor ring. So this ring around here, I'll wipe it off, is magnetically encoded with the teeth for your wheel speed sensor. So it's real similar to like the back of your credit card. So it has that magnetically encoded area there. So your wheel speed sensor is up in here. That's our wheel speed sensor. So that picks up that magnetic signal. So pretty simple deal there. So all we gotta do is reassemble now. Our new part, here's a good picture of that magnetic ring there. So be careful if you drop this or if it has any cracks or anything, it's ruined. So you need to make sure and be careful with that. So we're gonna put our dust shield back on. These do matter which way they go. So pay attention which way it came off on this application. So we're gonna line that back up and put our hub on. Drop one of the bolts in. It's going to help us align it. Get that bolt started. We got all four of those started. We're going to run them down this impact gun. Make sure we do it squared. So we want to torque those four bolts. Make sure they're the correct torque spec. We're also going to get our new axle nut. So these nuts, since it has that crimped section, are one-time use. So we'll get our new one here. See if we can get it started. We're going to use that to help pull our axle in the rest of the way. Snug. We need to torque this nut and all four of those bolts, and then we'll be ready to go back together. So we'll go ahead and put our rotor on in the meantime. So I'm going to clean this surface here because you want that surface between the rotor and the hub as clean as possible. No rust or debris, mud, anything like that. So we're going to put our rotor on, make sure and line up our rotor screws so we can secure our rotor back. So we're gonna run our rotor screws in. You can just snug them by hand. You wanna make sure they do, that rotor does seat up square. And then to snug these down, just be turning the impact driver in the direction that you want it to go. So we're going righty tighty. So a couple whacks like that. Plenty tight enough. So that's gonna hold that rotor on there just fine. So, now we have that on. All we have to do is reassemble these brakes and then torque our four bolts in the back and our one axle nut, and we'll have this job finished up. All right, now that we got the hub back in and the rotor back on, we're gonna torque our hub bolts. So they torqued a 73 foot-pounds on this one. So get all four of these torqued. Now that those are torqued, we need to torque our axle nut. So to do that, we're gonna put our brakes back in place. Now that we got our hub torqued down, we have our brakes reinstalled, we need to go ahead and torque this axle nut. So you can do this by putting the wheel back on and you can let the vehicle down with the weight of the vehicle on there and go through the wheel center cap and torque this. Or you can use a punch here against the brake stay and we're gonna torque this thing down. So this one torques down to 242 foot-pounds, so pretty tight. So pretty tight on that one. Then we have to take this nut and stake that notch down. So we're just gonna get a punch. We're gonna hit it right here to flatten that down in there. So now that it has that little dimple in there, that nut can't back off. So easy as that on a hub and bearing replacement on this one.